SCP-682 is not invulnerable. In fact, it is only very highly regenerative. Essentially, think Wolverine without the metal skeleton. And I know it's adamantine, coated, but let's just call it what it is. Metal skeleton. Anyway, it's Wolverine without that. It just has a very, very strong regeneration factor. And the SCP Foundation has tested... There's all these termination attempts of SCP-682. But the interesting thing is, it seems like they let it regenerate to some sort of level where it can actually fight back a little bit before they actually bother trying to kill it. And it always struck me as odd whenever I saw the tests, because they can acid it down to almost nothing, but they don't. Or they do, but then they let it regenerate some first. Like, if you read the article itself, it says that it can draw nutrition from any liquid solution. So it's actually drawing nutrition from the acid that they're using to keep it small and non-threatening. First of all, it's not the SCP Foundation's thing. The SCP Foundation is not at all about that life. They keep things in containment. They don't destroy them. Thinking about how you can destroy an SCP is basically, what if the GOC had control of it instead? Not even the to be fair, like, mainline continuity now at this point, the GOC isn't even a destroy organization. They're much more likely to take out something that they think of as a threat, but they're not like, let's just destroy everything. They become a little bit more nuanced than that. And I like to think that there's like this little bit of an inclination that everybody has in the back of their head is like, okay, yeah, here's it's like superheroes, right? We think of SCP-682 as Wolverine, then we have to think about, you know, what would happen if you put Wolverine up against the Incredible Hulk? What would happen if you put Wolverine up against Cyclops, etc., and so on and so forth? And we do that because in our minds we love the idea of mixing together two things that we like, right? But when we just straight up think about destroying something, that's not even like pitting one thing against another. Or maybe it is pitting one thing against the other. It's the thing we like, which is SCP-682, and another thing we like, which is wanton destruction. But regardless of that, there's nothing in SCP-682's article that indicates that it's immortal, that it'll live forever, or that it's impossible to destroy. It's just very hard to destroy. In fact, that's the name of the article is what? The Very Hard to Destroy Reptile? Even though it's not a reptile, it just seems like one. And the image is of a beluga whale skeleton that's been rotting for a while. Theoretically, let's assume we actually did want to destroy SCP-682. What would the best way to go about it be? Now, first of all, we know acid works. It doesn't destroy him, but it does keep it some sort of a balance at some point. It keeps it down to a certain level that's manageable. SCP-682's containment is affected through the use of hydrochloric acid, which is not a particular... I mean, it's a powerful acid, but it's not like some amazingly powerful acid like hydrofluoric acid, or there's others, but that's the first one that comes to mind. Like, we look at SCP-682 and we're like, let's throw it in hydrochloric acid, because I think the person that wrote it probably was thinking that's like the strongest acid they could think of. Just as if I were to be writing it, the strongest thing I could think of off the top of my head is hydrofluoric acid, and I'm sure there are better options than that, but not many, but there's some, I'm sure. The thing is, we haven't really got an opportunity to see how 682 adapts to everything. SCP-682, his thing is adaptation, not just regeneration, but adaptation. So, like, think Doomsday. It's a mixture. Yeah, let's look at that from that. We'll mix Marvel's Wolverine with Doomsday from the DC comics. Doomsday is somebody who, or I shouldn't say somebody, but Doomsday is a character that can regenerate, that's true, but also when you kill it one way, you can never kill it that way again. SCP-682 isn't quite like that, because if you shoot him, there's things he can't become immune to, but he can adapt to become more resistant to those things. He becomes resistant to acid. He can become resistant to high impact rounds. When they throw him with 173 the first time around, it gets him. And then he starts sprouting extra eyes so that he can always watch it. You know, there's little things like that. So the first thing you'd want to do is you'd want to overwhelm his adaptation. You would have to hit him with something that's never been he's never been hit with before, not even similar to something he's been hit with before. And you would need to make sure that whatever it is destroys him utterly. One thing that a lot of people will throw out is, what if we tried a nuclear bomb? Which, I mean, maybe, but why not try a stronger acid, since hydrochloric acid does such a good job already? And if that doesn't work, why don't you just try a basic incinerator? And it'd be like, well, we can't put it in an incinerator because, well, if you can put it in a vat of acid, you can put it in an incinerator. That's all I'm saying. So, like, honestly, if we're looking at it from the perspective of, like, just think about the infographics show's version, where they were like, let's just shoot it a lot, and or let's just nuke it. Like, nuking it as your first, like, even first or second option is sort of silly when you can do things that are essentially impossible. Like, if we're going to be punny about it, things that are a little bit less flashy than a nuclear bomb, like, say, oh, I don't know, an incinerator or just really strong acids. Acids stronger than hydrochloric, at least. Although, the better question is, why bother? It's not that, like, it says in the, you know, it's capable of incredible damage or whatever. Like, okay, fine. Why not just bury it? If you're really worried about, like, keeping it in containment, don't kill it. There's no first of all, there's no reason to kill it. Second of all, killing it is the hard thing to do. Keeping it in containment seems to be easier than killing it. So keep doing what you're doing. And if it's escaping a lot, put it in a position where it can't escape. Like right now, it's supposedly kept in a hydrochloric acid bath. Just put it underground, deep underground, and pile a bunch of dirt on top of it. It's strong, but it's not going to be strong enough to lift up the entire, you know, like to lift up several hundred or even several thousand or several tens of thousands of tons of dirt. You'd be like, what if it learns to burrow? Like, it adapts to death things. It doesn't, like, become capable of doing whatever it wants whenever it wants. I don't know. SCP-682 is one of the, and it's not just 682 that people want to kill off. 682 is just the one that's like, come at me, bro, basically. Because it's the one that is supposed to be very difficult to destroy, or at least, if not impossible, very difficult. But you've got, I mean, all of these SCPs out there that are resistant. Like, that's if you look at Series 1 articles, highly resistant to damage or regenerative is like a basic factor. Like, everything has that, to a level where it's not even all that interesting as a concept anymore. And the SCP-682 is literally just that. Like, some of the other, like, SCP-096 at least has, you know, a mechanism that's interesting about it. I don't think that we need to destroy these things. I think it makes far, like I said, it makes far more sense to just keep them contained. And when we're talking about something like 682, it seems like it's actually easier to keep it contained than it is to try and kill it. So, you know, keep doing what you're doing. Maybe do it better, but that's about it. Anyway, that's it. Thank you very much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please hit the subscribe button and then the notification bell next to that so you're notified when I upload new videos. And then, if you really want to support the channel, head on over to patreon.com/dcimmerian and pledge at any level like everybody here on the screen already has, including Vivi, Dr. J Redacted, and Lawful Evil. It's nice to know that I'm not alone out here, and I'll see you all again on Tuesday.